In part 5, we've printed a list from some data cards, but there was an error in the program. You may see that the last card is missing in the printout. The printout stops with the card before the last card. This is because of an error in the program flow. This select is at the wrong position. Maybe it becomes more obvious if we rephrase the question. Was the last card is related to the card we've read with the previous read command? That means if the condition is true, it is indeed the last card, but of course it still has to be processed. If it isn't processed, the related output will be missing. The solution is to move the select to the end of the card processing. If it wasn't the card, we go back to read the next one. If it was the last card, we exit to the end. This is easy to fix also in the machine program. We only have to create new cards for this part of the program. Let's give it a try. I've already prepared the corrected cards. But first, let's have a look at the wrong program. Take the program cards. These are the data cards. The last one is with the 615. Put them behind the program cards. Put the stack into the card reader. Set the 1401 to run mode. Press check reset, start reset. Press load. Let's open the list. Set the instruction pointer to 501. Run mode. Check reset, start reset, start. And we get a list which doesn't include the 615. Okay, close the printout. Let's take our stack, go over to the tray. These are all the data cards. This is the last program card. Okay. 1, 2. So we have card 3, 4, 5. Let's take them out. Throw them away. Now take the correct cards, put them here, put the stack together again, last one is still 615, take the stack, put it into the card reader, mode is run, check reset, start reset, press load. Press alter, set the address to 501. Check reset, start reset, run mode. Open the list. Start. And now, as you can see, the list includes the last card with the 615. So the new program works correctly.